appointed to encourage marksmanship among the people of the country, primarily young men who can be expected in time to serve in uniform. And of course, you know as well as I do the very great importance of marksmanship among those in uniform.
My basic objection is that it's not meeting its mission. The justification for it is that it trains future combat riflemen. And their own study, the Arthur B. Little Report, showed that only 3% of Army trainees had participated in the program, and that the other 97%, most of them, could be quickly brought up to the same proficiency with a little extra training, so that it's just $3 to $5 million that I believe, based on the facts, that is being largely wasted.
Both of these circumstances, people that were pledged, members of an organization pledged to the overthrow of the government by forceful means. I feel that this presents a very real threat, particularly in major cities all over the country. And the accessibility of weapons adds to this threat. By just belonging to the National Rifleman's Association, a particular chapter, they have the accessibility. And the provisions which are made by the NRA to police these find individuals who belong and find out where they're good, upstanding citizens is completely inadequate, completely inadequate.
Well, a very definite effort is made to avoid weapons getting into the hands of extremists, and I think with very few exceptions, the effort has been successful. But that is the purpose of channeling these weapons through an organization which can screen the recipients and screen the club.
There's no more justification for the federal government spending $2,700,000 out here for the conduct of these matches than it would be to spend that kind of money for a national chess tournament or a national bridge tournament. It doesn't relate to any public need. It trains a special group of citizens, private citizens, for their own private purposes. I see no national benefit from it whatsoever.
Now, I think if we were to stop the national marksmanship matches in Camp Perry, and this is the only place that is set up for these matches, that we would be surrendering the leadership which American marksmen have in the world. We now are on top again. For a while, the Russians were way ahead of us in world marksmanship matches. Now we're on top again.
The Camp Perry shoots, in all respects, are very similar to the World Series in baseball. This brings out the best in the country's marksmen. And as far as the money expenditure is concerned, why, in my opinion, they spend a lot of money more foolishly than that.
Now, I just wonder why the federal government, why the Defense Department, should be subsidizing a sporting match. That, in effect, is what these rifle marksmanship programs are. They're a sporting match out of Camp Perry. And the federal government is financing and supporting that.